talked about the recent acquisition of Intergraph with Hexagon. And joining us today is the CEO of Hexagon Group, Ula Rolen. I've met Ula a number of months ago, and I can tell you he's a sharp mind, quick wit, and a quick study. And we're excited for this forum today where he will share his vision for the future of Intergraph, and you'll find his interest is high and his commitment is strong to our people and products. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to welcome on stage Mr. Ula Rolen.
Welcome. I think we have to give it to who all say the management team and all the employees of Intergraph. I think you have a fantastic week to look forward to. I'm stunned. I was also stunned by the bed last night. I came in quite late from Europe and I slept like a log. I think the only thing that I had to figure out was what the clean cleansing was. But it's a washout town. What we got over here is our new technology, the point cloud scanning technology, where we're trying to discern Mount Rushmore. And I think this is an important technology when looking at combining Intergraph and Hexagon's joint technology basket. I'm going to speak a bit about Hexagon today, introduce it to you. I'm going to take you through our business operations, acquisition rationale, why we want to acquire Intergraph, and then going forward, what will happen next. Hexagon in brief, our business mission is to measure objects in one, two, or three dimensions. And if you think about it, more and more applications are being measured in three dimensions. Furthermore, when you start to measure, it's also important to position objects using GPS technologies and so forth. And with Intergraph, we also acquire the capability to design and redesign objects using reverse engineering in processes and so on. And we're also involved in timing processes in utilities and other applications. Hexagon started back in 2000. It existed earlier on, but not in the capacity and capability as we know it today. It was a small Scandinavian conglomerate, and the principal shareholder bought its stake in 1998, and he recruited me back in 2000, and he basically told me that, Ula, I've failed, I lost a lot of money, and I don't think you can screw it up much more. On that note, we got started, and I don't know, I mean, I've always been in industry, and the business mission, business scope has never been a question. But this was the first time in my life I had to sit down and say, what will this company be when we grow up? And like everything in life, we grabbed opportunity, we didn't get a hair, but we got to run a shop, which was a US company listed on New York Stock Exchange, and it was basically bankrupt when we acquired it back in 2001. But with Brown & Sharpe, we got the capability to measure in three dimensions, and that was the starting point. As a follow-up acquisition, we acquired the Swiss-based measurement company Leica Geosystems back in 2005. And in 2007, we bought the Canadian, the Calgary-based company, Novatel, which won our technology division. And with those three building blocks, we could measure, we could describe measurements, and we could feed systems like GIS systems and CAD systems. That's basically what we do today. And the next step is obviously to integrate that information that you capture by measuring the real world into the so-called modern one, 3D one, CAD, GIS. And that's where Intergraph comes into the picture. And with Intergraph, we think that we can make dedicated solutions to you, where you can have a quick update on events that is happening in real life, or changes to the designs, and so forth. We're supposed to flip them. There. We're listed on Nasdaq OMX. Nasdaq has acquired an awful lot of stock exchanges in Europe, so they're all called Nasdaq, and then the addition is the local stock market, and this would be the one in Stockholm. And we're headquartered in Stockholm, but we know more than 10 people in the head office, actually. Our senior management, though, represents more than 10 nationalities. And we believe in being local everywhere where we're active. It's also a high technology company. We have roughly 1,700 patents. We file more than 200 patent applications every year. And we talked about, and I was also talking about product regeneration, and we change our portfolio every 18 months. We believe in something that we refer to as the Coca-Cola principle, and that means that it shouldn't come as a surprise to you. You can look it up at YouTube, where you have the Pepsi advertisement and the Coca-Cola advertisement, and there's a really fun one about Jimi Hendrix that I recommend. But what does it mean in practice? Being number one or being number two? The globe is shrinking. You can't afford to be everywhere, and you need to grow to a certain size. And we believe that we serve you better if we're number one or number two in our industry. And Intergraph fulfills that prerequisite, which is great. And with that size, we can bring down cost, we can bring out innovation, and we think that's really the way forward to succeed. As you can see, geographically, China became our largest market this year. So I have to concur with those, it's a great opportunity. China represents 20% of our sales in the second quarter of this year. Business operations, quickly look at our products. We're organized in three divisions: geosystems, metrology, and technology. But underneath these three divisions, they share a lot of commonalities, platforms, and R&D, like algorithms, mathematical algorithms, 3D modeling, digitizing, and so forth. Geosystems, which is the largest division and the one most known to you probably, has a wide array of technologies to do multi-dimensional positioning. Customers would typically be surveyors, mapping organizations, construction, civil engineering, government bodies, architects, real estate, and defense-related customers. But the growth drivers, and what's really interesting about this business in this moment in time, is it's very much about the global infrastructure way. Update terrestrial information, bring down cost in production processes, construction processes, verify that you're actually doing what you're planning to do.